you firmly believe that he was wrong about the fact that Republicans are going to take control of one or both houses in November?
Yeah, you know,
I didn't say this.
Nobody. Oh, really? I said
one or more.
Walking that back a little bit. Okay. Yeah. You know, Tavis, I think that many of the media storylines over and over have been wrong. Mm. Obama can't win these votes. He can't win this. He'll never be Hillary. This will never happen. He'll never win these white people. He'll never do this. And, you know, so I love watching media storylines be
but
wrong. The Democrats
Virginia,
are going to take a beating.
New Jersey,
I mean, they always lose seats.
But
that's historic.
Hold on, Daniel, a second. It is true, though, Stephanie, to your point now, it is true that there are a lot of candidates now who don't want the president to campaign with them. We saw the story in Texas. You know, this is happening in a few places now where people want to shun the president campaigning with them.
This happened during the Bush presidency. Mm-hmm. There's always incumbent fatigue. I'm not comparing the two.
According to Rick Perry, Texas may not even be part of the union by November. So, you know, it may not really be an issue.
This always happens. There's always a walk back in more conservative states or more liberal states from an incumbent president at the time during midterm elections. Mm-hmm. There are always seats lost by the opposing party during the second midterm elections. This is not
pundits
already started
it is,
now.
This is not true. George W. Bush won seats in 2002.
There have been individual occurrences over the last 100
George
years.
George W. Bush won seats in 2002. He picked up seats in 2002.
There he is. Ladies and gentlemen, there's a lot more. Stephanie, 1 second. There's a lot more to talk about with regard to the midterm elections. As you can see, we're just getting started here on this part of the conversation. So we'll talk more about what effect these issues and others will have on the midterm elections, given that tonight there are some major primaries happening across the country. We'll talk more about that in a moment here on Larry King Live. We were talking here during the break on Larry King Live with our panel about the fact that if, in fact, the Democrats lose the House and or the Senate come November, Stephanie, that it will likely be due to the economic condition, the fact that too many Americans are jobless. And we were making the point during the break here that when President Obama signed a unemployment benefits bill a few weeks ago, Shirley Sherrod, that story made him disappear with that major piece of legislation being signed. So today, $26 billion jobs bill, and we've got the issue of Congressman Rangel, the issue of Congresswoman Maxine Waters, the plane crash of Senator Ted Stevens. So this story not being discussed perhaps as much as it might on another day. Here's the question, though. The jobs bill, is it enough? Is it too late? And am I right about the fact that if Democrats lose in November, it's going to be because they could not stimulate enough jobs in this economy?
Well, I mean, I get your point about the 24-hour news cycle. I mean, you're right. You know, here we get all this help to unemployed Americans, and Fox News is 24/7 going, look, a black lady said something. And then
oh, good grief.
It turned out to be nothing. You know, and you're right.
People who are talking about this perpetuating
race. Excuse me, Dana.
1 second,
I'm just calling you out.
But you're right. This is important. No. Excuse me?
Did I distract you?
I'm playing the race card.
Did I distract you?
Card?
I did.
Well, Fox
yeah, I'm calling BS
Fox
and you
News
constantly
didn't play the race
it
card.
Pull it out. Pull it out. Can you not argue the issues? You have a radio show. Be prepared. Quit throwing the race card out every second that you get. Jeez.
Excuse me?
Wait a second. Let's try.
Can you
talk
the job? I would like to point out.
I would like to point out one thing that we were
Fox
talking
News
about.
Fox News didn't play the race card with Shirley Sherrod. We're talking about
the race card.
You may disagree,
either
but
you know the issues or you
policy
don't.
Policy things
quit
done,
throwing the
like
race
unemployment,
card.
Like
love,
jobs
I would
bill.
Love to not get yelled at.
Dana, 1 second. Thank
my
you.
My blood's going to start shooting out of my ear.
One thing that I think
we're talking about the jobs bill, ladies and gentlemen.
And I think that one thing that this discussion points up is that we spend a lot of time arguing about who's going to get reelected, who's going to be in office, who's going to be thrown out of office, and not enough talking about how we're going to get things done in this country. You know, look, I'm a progressive, but I've a lot of conservative friends. And when we have a conversation, we're not screaming at each other about who's wrong and who's right. We're trying to figure out how we're going to move the country forward. And I think we're so focused in the 24-hour news cycle of creating scandal and drama and hits and quotes on what's scandalous
and
not enough on how are
Dana,
we going to improve
my,
this
listen,
country.
My mom is an 87-year-old Republican George Bush fan.
I'm talking
my,
to everybody.
My father ran for vice president with Barry Goldwater. I can talk to a lot of Republicans
Stephanie,
about
it's kind of hard when you sit here and go,
so
Tavis is racist.
Tavis is asking about the jobs bill.
Let's talk about the jobs bill. What do you know about
Dana,
it? Because he's asked you about
Dana,
it and you keep deflecting.
Dana, let me ask you about the jobs bill. Go.
Yes. jobs
You're
bill.
On.
I think
about
it's ridiculous.
Yes.
You do not stimulate the economy by continuing to throw bailout after bailout at it. The whole thing about this $26 billion bill, I find it interesting that the food stamp program had to be raided in order to facilitate this bill. $50 million out of this bill is going to be going into the pockets of unions. If you think about teachers' unions, 160,000 teachers in this country, if you consider that only half of them are unionized, if you look in union dues, $300-something for the NEA, $196-something for the Federated Teachers of America, all of this stuff. Modestly speaking, $50 million of that goes back into unions' pockets. Why are we doing another educational jobs bailout bill when we still have over $30 million that could be spent? We had $100 billion that went to go towards states.
Stephanie, unless you're... What would you do to create jobs? What would you do?
I would lay off businesses, and I would provide tax cuts to people, and I would not keep creating public sector jobs. Because people do not realize that private sector pays for the public sector.
I think people do realize
that. That's what I do.
I think a lot of Americans do realize that, but I also think that almost every established economist in this country has said, there's consensus, broad and widespread consensus, that most of the bailout package has worked. It has protected jobs, it has created new jobs. The government can only do so much, and I think we all agree on that, but the government is doing what's in its power to do. There have been multiple tax cuts to business over the last year.
We got to go to a break. We could debate that. I, in fact, respectfully would debate you on that, about whether or not the government has done enough, whether or not the stimulus bill has been enough. Paul Krugman doesn't see it that way.
No, exactly.
And there are a lot of other folk that don't see it that way, but I digress on that point. When I come back from the break, Hugh, I want to come to you because, believe it or not, there was other news today. It wasn't just that the president signed a $26 billion jobs bill today. The House also passed a $600 million border security bill today. The Senate passed a bill similar some days ago. So there was some movement, it would appear, today on the notion of immigration reform. We'll talk about that in just a moment after this break and more of Larry King Live. Breaking news here, the Associated Press now projecting former WWE executive Linda McMahon, the winner of the Connecticut GOP primary for the Senate with 58% of the vote in. AP shows McMahon with a 19-point lead over former Congressman Simmons. So, Hugh, that's good news for you, I take it?
Well, I'm indifferent on the Connecticut primary. I'm very interested in the Colorado one where it's neck and neck this late. I was behind Jay Norton on that. Tavis, I got to go back and just correct one bit of the record because facts are stubborn things. In 2002, the first off-year election for George W. Bush, House Republicans picked up 8 seats. In the Senate, they picked up 2 seats. And so, in fact, the repudiation underway of President Obama is unprecedented in this millennium. It's going to be devastating to lose the House of Representatives and many Senate seats. And it represents an enormous pushback against a failed economic policy. And I beg to differ. It isn't a jobs bill. It's a public sector employee bailout. It's $26 billion we don't have. The American people want it to happen. And yes?
But when you say this repudiation of President Obama, what repudiation? Nothing's happened yet. The election's until November.
USA Today, 41% approval rating. The most precipitous drop, in a presidential approval for a first-term president you have ever seen. 41%.
No, that's not true.
And that is going to continue because Barack Obama has lost the confidence of the American people. He's in over his head.
Let me ask you, Hugh, whether or not he and the Democrats can gain some of that confidence back with things like this. Today, a $600 million border security bill passed. As I mentioned, that happened in the House. The Senate did something similar days ago, so now they'll come to conference committee and work this bill out. Is this a step in the right direction for those who think that we're not taking illegal immigration seriously enough? Is this going to comfort them in any way?
No, you know, it's not a conference committee that next Tavis. The Senate began that, and a spending bill has to originate in the House, so they passed the same bill in the House. It's supposed to pass on unanimous consent when the Senate comes back. But it's a joke, and the country knows that the Democrats don't care about the border security. They're not caring about the fence.
Wait a second.
It's a ruse. It's a very thinly disguised ruse, and it's not going to work for anyone who actually cares about border security. They're not going to trust Nancy Pelosi.
Arrests and deportations are up under Barack Obama than George Bush. So George Bush cared about border security? Is that
it's
what
not
you're implying?
Of Barack Obama, though.
Yes, it is. Yes,
it sheriff.
Is. When you say
really
$600 million is a joke, that's a serious bill, yes?
I think it's a joke that Democrats put forward, $600 million. People will not believe it will be spent effectively to build the fence, what the American people want. So, and it's like 90% consensus on this, is secure the border and then regularize the
illegals. Yes, they want comprehensive immigration reform. First, that's
and
the consensus.
Nothing has happened
Republicans
under this
don't
Secretary
want comprehensive immigration reform. They don't.
That's what I should
this,
again,
is the, this is the point that I would
I'm
like
happy
to make.
To talk about it
I'd
at
like
length,
to just,
but the fact remains
like
on the Democratic
restate,
side, it's always a filibuster.
I'd just like to restate what we talk about too much in this country is about why the other side is wrong. And not and I feel like we can never concede that anybody's motivations might actually be genuine, that the president might actually care about improving border security, that we might actually be moving in the right direction. Maybe we're not there yet. That it's like no matter how much money he spends, somehow his motivations are off. He's doing something. Let's support it. Let's move forward.